You know, we're talking about this as we're in Colossians. We're talking about a series that we've called Transformed. And that word transformation or transformed is this idea that we are just, we're completely different, which is the Bible teaches that because of Jesus Christ, we should live lives that are completely different than the way it used to be. The Bible uses illustrations such as we are a new creation now. You're a completely new being, a new creation. The old has gone and new things have come. And do you feel that way? Do you believe that? When you look at who you are in Jesus Christ because of your belief in Him now, because He's come into your life, do you see yourself as a completely different being than you were before you knew Jesus? Has there been this transformation in your life, or is it just kind of a little tweaking of the old you? You know, that yeah, I've got a few little differences now that I'm a Christian. Now I show up to church. Now I don't cuss so much. You know, or has it really been a transformation of the way you think? Like everything is gone now. Everything is different now that Jesus has come into my life. That's what God is after. That's what He desires of us. It is that verse in when we hear that word transformed, we think of Romans 12, verse 2, where it says, "Do not conform any longer to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you'll be able to test and approve what God's will is, His good, pleasing, and perfect will." See, the Bible tells us, don't conform to the pattern of this world. And something I've been noticing is I do a lot of things because everyone else does them this way. I just follow patterns. It's easy to follow a pattern, right? And there's a way, there are so many things that we do in America that are very American, and we just think, well, that's the only way to do it, because that's the pattern that's been set forth for me. And yet the Bible says, don't conform to the pattern of this world, but He wants our thinking to be different. He goes, I want you to transform your thinking. Think the way that God thinks. And then you'll be able to prove what His will is. Don't think about what everyone's doing, what the flow is doing. Think about what is God's perfect, pleasing will and start pursuing that. See, that's God's desire for our lives. That's His desire for His people. And you guys, I used to read certain portions of the Bible and think, well, that was for back then. You know, we can't really do that today living in America. You know, I read about the early church and the way they were so in love with each other and how they cared for one another. I go, well, you know what? They lived more communally back then, and we're more of an individualistic society and this and that. And yet this week, as I was studying Colossians and I was looking a little bit more at the background of this church, I realized that they lived in a pretty crazy culture also. That they were under the Roman Empire, and there was a lot of pressure to just do as the Roman Empire tells you to do. That was a very strong empire. You know, people were worshiping Caesar, lifting up this leader and everything else. And then they had all this religious baggage and everything else from their previous religious traditions. And yet what God called them to do was, don't follow that pattern. I want you to be different. I want you to live differently. And He's saying the same thing to us. So it doesn't matter that you're living in the 21st century. You think things are really that different now? People have always been about themselves, but I'm asking you not to follow that pattern. I want you to not think, well, how do Americans live? I want you to test out and figure out, here's the pattern I've set out for you. This has always been the pattern. Doesn't matter what the rest of the world does. I have a pattern for you, and it's in this book. So don't conform to the pattern of the world. We have traditions in this room that you guys were brought up in Baptist churches, evangelical churches, Catholic churches, Presbyterian churches, all these different churches. But have you really stopped to think, okay, what is really biblical? What do I really find the pattern in this book? And what have I done because it was just the way that I was raised? See, God says, don't just conform to these patterns. See, a lot of times I've just assumed that certain things we've done in church, well, this is what all evangelical Christians do. And so let's just do it, and let's do it a little bit better. And then you realize, wait a second, now let me just erase everything. And let me go back to this book, and how does it say I ought to live? Because I'm supposed to be transformed in my thinking. I've pretty much understood the thought that I, as an individual, am supposed to live differently than other individuals in the world.